Hello guys, this is Kinga and welcome to On Her Bike channel. Today I'll be sharing with you my thoughts about long rider motorbikes and the other bikes from long rider. I've got a few of them, so the full range. So the most common question you guys ask me is, why did I swap from aluminium panniers to long rider bags? The answer is very simple: safety. I traveled with aluminium panniers for years, 5-7 years, since I bought my first GS. And the reason I love them so much is because it was easy to access them, it was easy to organize your things there. And you could put cool stickers on it. Like, yeah, that part was really cool. But unfortunately, it happens to me on my roundabout travels a few times that I nearly broke my leg because of the aluminium panniers. So sometimes you're on a tricky terrain and your foot gets stuck there, and then it's really easy to injure your leg with the force of aluminium pannier. So I've been using these bags in the last 10 months in Africa intensively. Yes, I did drop it a couple of times, but as you can see, they're still in perfect shape. They're made of really durable material. They have this rubber covers on the edges that, you know, it's for extra protection, and they're really solid. So the way they're designed, you know, if you fall, they will flex a bit because they are semi-rigid. So what I love about them the most is that they are very spacious. I've got 38 liters here, 31 on the other side because of the exhaust pipe. The bike is smaller and they're so easy to access. So they only have like three buckle system, 1, 2, and then underneath is the third one. And there you go, the bag is open. Another thing that I love about this bag is you have a lot of these points where you can attach things, right? So long rider came with a full range of products with, like, in terms of small bags and bottle holders. I'll cover that, what I'm using on my bike, soon. But you don't have to buy long rider products. You can, like, for example, this is just, you know, random fuel bottle. You can just attach anything to these bikes, which is so handy when you travel overland. Okay, so let's see what's inside. Surprise, another bag. So long rider designed special inner bags for these bags, which are, ta-da! So this is how inner bag looks like. You can just sort of fold it, make it smaller if it's needed. And then there you go, you've got like a nice little bag that you can take anywhere. And the bags are not waterproof, and the way they are designed, if the water gets in between your liner and the bag, there are holes here, you see? So that it just drips out. So it's very clever and simple. Hey, cat. What's going on? No way. How's your day? No attention. Silence. I'm working here. Please. Say hi to people. Okay, and now go. I'm working here. So my bags are fixed to the plate with the screws. So it's very time consuming to take them off. But recently Long Rider came up with a solution of the quick release system. So you can purchase this, it's already available. I'm gonna have to do this upgrade very soon. Even as they are now, there is option of folding them. I'm not gonna do it because it's just that I have a lot of things attached and I'm on the road now in Africa. So I just don't wanna touch it for now. But it's really easy to do. So if you're doing off-road, you can just fold them and they that wide, so they're out of your way. The great thing about motorbikes in terms of safety is that you can lock them. So this is long rider lock. I don't know, you can like do code like 1111, for example. And then you've got this little solid thingy here that you can put your lock, and there you go. That's all you need to do. you can leave your bike now and just go do shopping or whatever you want to do without worrying that your stuff can be stolen. You like my bags? You want to touch them? How was it? How was it? Don't scratch it! Yes, we can now, we know that it's also scratch proof. Cat scratch proof. Okay, ready? Let's go. So now it's time to cover the other long rider bags. Around 5 months ago, yeah, long rider sent me this new range of bags that you can easily attach to the motor bags, and I love this guy so much. I don't travel light, don't judge me, I just don't. I tried, but I'm on the road now 4 years and I still haven't learned how to travel light. I just need stuff, but that's okay. It's that I'm the one who's riding the bike, right? At the back I have two tall bags, so they're coming with all the straps which are makes them so easy to attach to the motor bags. All these bags are waterproof and they are really made out of super durable and premium material. Like, they really feel such great quality. So they're easy to access. You can have, I don't know, like for example, I've got a towel, I've got a chain loop, you know, like umbrella, you know, all these things that you have to carry for around the world. And these ones here are mini bags, which are sort of bigger than the tall or micro bags. So I always have it at the front here on the engine guards. I use Outback MotorTech engine guards. I think these guys are the best ones out there. I've been using them for years and I just love them because the way they shape the guards, you can attach so many things without a problem. So I've got lights, I've got cowbell, I've got mounts for the camera, I've got it all. And also the mini bag from Long Rider fits so well on them. So I normally would have something light here, like bike covers, stickers for the kids, and just like, you know, bits and pieces that are not too heavy so you don't have this weight at the front. So have a look at this bag now. It's empty, right? But it's still in such nice shape. It's I'm so impressed with the quality of this mini bags. So the way you open it is you just release here and here and then unroll it. Done. You've got access to your bag. And this one has 6 liters capacity. And I also have a Long Rider bottle holder for my fuel bottle for my cooking stove. And this is so simple. Just what you put the bottle in, you strap it with one strap, and it's so easy to attach it to the Long Rider bag. So simple and perfect. I really like that solution. And another thing that's good about these bags is you can overload them. Yes, it's possible. You can't do that with your aluminium harness. But with this, for example, now I'm only sort of dropped all my gear at the capital city and I went for like a 1-2 week trip. So I didn't need all my stuff with me. So I overloaded them. So you can still tension the straps. It's still quite secure, although I'm not sure if it's still waterproof. But it's perfectly fine for the dry season, I reckon. You never guess what happened. As I was editing this review, I realized I completely forgot to mention about another Long Rider bag, which is the Overlander. So now I'm gonna do a quick review here in the middle of nowhere. All right, so this is my main luggage. This is my main bag that I always carry with me pretty much everywhere, because sometimes if I'm staying in a hostel, everything is locked in those big bags like food and camping stuff, and this bag goes always with me. This bag, I think, has got absolutely awesome design. It's, you know, made out of very durable material, as all Long Rider bags. So let's start from the top. This is really cool. Have a look at this. You disattach it. This is like your little folder thingy. So you've got a pocket here that's waterproof. I keep like just bags there. But you can put your maps here and you can turn it like that. You can attach it like that. So as you please. So this is a really cool little feature. Then what we've got? Then we have a pocket here. Waterproof one, very cool. Then we have another pocket on the side, very cool. On this one now. All right, and then how we open it and close it is very, very simple. The way it works, roll, sort of roll bag. And if you roll it properly, the bag will be waterproof. And then you attach it here and here and here. That goes on top. This is the way I'm using it. And that's it. And Overland has two straps, so pretty much you can just, you know, carry it like that. Or you can carry it as a backpack, which goes, I think, this way. And that's so easy when you have to climb up the stairs in a hostel and just like go like this. So nice. Right, so this is how I travel with this bag. Lone Rider provides you with these extra straps that you can attach to the bike. Unfortunately, I misplaced them, so I only travel now with rock straps. So I just connect rock straps underneath this folder thingy. I don't know, it's just like, it looks really nice this way. And yeah, and you can have access to your quick stuff with this folder sort of cover. And you probably already noticed that I have new red straps on my motorbikes. I recently received them from Lone Rider, and I think they just give the bags different look and they match my red frame. So I absolutely love it. It's just small detail, but yet big difference. And last product from Lone Rider is the tool roll, which I have recently received as well. The size of the tool roll is pretty much, I don't know, won't even probably take half of your mini bag, so you can carry here, it here, or somewhere else, whatever you wish. I carry it normally at the back, so because of the weight. So this is when you unroll it, this is how it looks like. Look, this is so clever. So you've got this little thing, well, it's disattachable, so you don't have to carry it if you don't want to, but it's a really great option if you have a lot of screws or nuts, whatever. You can just, this is your sort of like working area. Then you have space for the tools and four little pockets which are disattachable as well. And then yeah, I just put some bits and pieces there as well. So I think it's a fantastic design. By far it's my favorite. Well, by far it's the best one I've ever owned. Very clever design. Thank you so much for that, Lone Rider. It will really last me for a long time, I think. And this is the end of the review. I hope I was able to give you some info on Lone Rider motorbikes, and now you can make a call if these bags are suitable for your preferences. I personally love them, and I will continue my African travels with this setup, the way my bike is set up now. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and join me on my round the world trip. Kotek is saying goodbye as well. Bye! Bye-bye! Bye!